Over the past few years, FICCI and the Indian Navy have partnered to organize flagship industry seminars which have dwelled on strategic and topical issues. Continuing this strong partnership, FICCI and the Indian Navy have joined hands together to brainstorm a strategy which has been successfully implemented by the major maritime powers of the world, nation building through shipbuilding. It is not often realized, but the fact that shipbuilding has a direct relationship with nation building. Vibrant shipbuilding industry has contributed to the economy and security of the most great powers, since it directly impacts national GDP and generates demand both in the upstream and downstream sectors of the economy. The multiplier for job creation is upward of 36 to 50 times the shipyard strength. India ranks as the 16th largest maritime nation. However, when evaluated against global indicators, India's record as a maritime nation is not encouraging. As per the UNCTAD report 2018, India's maritime indicators as a proportion of global aggregates have tremendous potential for improvement and gathering a large market share of the ocean economy. With a global population of 17.74% and GDP share of 3.2% and about 4% of the global Exim trade, India's shipping fleet has less than 1% and India's shipbuilding is less than 0.15% of the global share. These telling parameters clearly do not reflect positively on our mercantile shipping and shipbuilding credentials. It is evident that the situation is not aligned with India's drive towards becoming a top player in international trade and commerce, particularly in manufacturing, commodities, and goods. As an illustration, India pays out about $50 to $60 billion for imports on foreign hulls. Only 7% of Indian Exim cargo are carried on Indian ships, and the sector has not attracted any significant FDI. India's mercantile fleet amounts to only 0.1% of the global fleet. Further, India is forced to relax cabotage as indigenous capacity to carry the potential cargo of more than 300 million metric tons per annum, coastal cargo is very limited. The participation by the various user ministries and departments has been tepid, preferring imports over domestic sourcing. The shipbuilding industry has immense potential for a rapidly growing economy, targeting a $5 trillion by 2025, provided it receives greater support from all stakeholders. It requires the same attention and promotion that warship building has been accorded. The shipbuilding industry requires strong government support for its initial growth and sustainability on the same lines that was done in the US, Japan, South Korea, and China. More recently, Vietnam and Philippines have put shipbuilding on the national agenda and rank far ahead of India in terms of shipbuilding, though India has equal, if not better, capability and skill set. The government's thrust on port-led development through the Sagarmala program, development of inland waterways, seabed exploration, deep-sea fishing, cruise tourism, and island development are extremely significant opportunities to grow the shipbuilding and shipping industry. This conference is the first of its kind where various stakeholders have come together on a common platform to devise the way forward for the industry. We have the talent, we have the infrastructure, we have the market, and we could raise the finance to working together with the government to achieve nation building through shipbuilding. Thank you very much.